Thank you for calling Intercredit. To pay by debit or credit card, please press 1 now. If you need to speak with an operator, press 2. All calls may be recorded for quality purposes.
One moment, please.
Intercredit, good morning.
Good morning.
How do I can help?
Could I speak to Kay King, please?
Sure, have you got a case number on the letter?
I do have a case number, yes.
Yep.
It is 51440394-4.
That's brilliant. And your full name and the first name of your address?
I will not be giving you my name, I will not be giving you my address. I will not be giving you any joinder whatsoever. All I've done is phoned up and asked you if I can speak to Kay King, please.
You're through to the same department, so we wouldn't be able to transfer your call.
Right. Now, just give me a second, please, okay? What's your name, please, my friend?
It's Phil.
Hello, Phil.
Hey.
Right. Now, please, treat me with a little bit of respect, Phil, okay? That's all I ask. Please don't lie to me, because I am recording this phone call myself for my own personal security, okay? Right. Now, you only want me to give you a name and an address as joinder for this account, don't you? It's nothing nothing to do with security, okay? A letter has been sent to my house, addressed to somebody and somebody else. And it's not even been signed by anybody, it's just a printed letter. In this letter, you are threatening to take somebody to court over an alleged debt with local council. Now, like I said, I will not be giving you any joinder whatsoever because I do not own this debt. You own this debt. You bought it, you are liable for it, not me. I'm in touch with my local MP about this situation. If any more letters come from yourself to this address, I will be taking legal action against your company. Is that understood?
You have to do what you have to do, sir, because at the end of the day, we need to establish who's liable to pay for the utility bills at the property. So if you're not prepared to give any information, then I can't really assist you any further, Mr. Sir.
No, you only want me to give you a name and the address, because then it is joinder on the account. It is a verbal agreement that I own the account, but I do not own the account. Okay?
You're not the person in question, basically, no?
I am not giving you any joinder on the account whatsoever. I am telling you, I am telling you that you have sent somebody round to my door. I recorded this person. This person broke data protection by littering, leaving personal information lying on the floor, which he never retrieved. I have this on video.
Thanks for your call, Mr. Sir. Okay.
No, I will only be phoning back up.
You can phone back as many times as you want, but no one here is going to discuss any information with someone that just calls in without any information. So, like I said,
no, what you mean is you'll not talk with anybody unless you've got a joinder with them.
Okay.
You mean you will not talk to anybody unless they give you a joinder? That's what you mean.
I can't. It's pointless me speaking to you because I don't know who I'm speaking to. We need to comply with data protection.
No, it's not data protection whatsoever.
Like you said you was going to do, sir.
It's not data protection whatsoever.
Okay, well, that's the end of the call then, I'll take it.
I'm not that person.
Okay, well, that's all you need to say. Okay, so you need to register yourself with the utility company if you're not the person in question.
So, are you going to stop sending your threatening letters to this address then?
As long as you register yourself with Affinity Water to confirm that you are paying your own water bills, then yeah, you'll get a letter stopped there.
And what happens if you send me another letter?
Well, as I said, it's not going to stop until you confirm with the water company that you're living there and that you're paying for your water, because the water's not free.
Excuse me, water's not free. Oh, okay then. So, do we have to pay to go swimming in the ocean?
We're going around in circles.
No, no, do we have to pay to go swimming in the ocean, do we?
If you want to get your solicitors to call us, please do. Okay?
All right, well, good luck trying to extort money out of other people, then.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Fucking idiots.
Press 1. To change your address details, press 2. If you have an up-to-date meter reading for us, please press 3. To tell us you have paid a recent bill, press 4. If you're calling about an issue with your fresh water supply or a leak, please press 5. For sewerage or drainage queries, please press 6. For anything else, please hold to speak with an advisor. If you would like to hear these options again, press 9. We're currently experiencing longer queuing times than normal. Many of our customers are now resolving their own queries online at www.affinitywater.co.uk using the My Account button. That web address again is www.affinitywater.co.uk. Alternatively, please continue to hold and we will answer your call as soon as a customer service advisor becomes available. Thank you.
I don't have a customer number at the moment, I'm afraid, love.
Okay.
It's just a general inquiry.
Okay, how can I help?
Basically, it's about, I have received a letter from a company called Intercredit International Limited.
Okay.
And apparently, this company will... Viola Water, Affinity Water, you are a client of theirs.
Mm-hmm.
Right, well, I know that Intercredit International Limited are a collection agency. They're a third-party interloper.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm, is that yes? Are you agreeing with me?
Yes, absolutely, sir, but...
Right, okay, right, so they are a third-party interloper. Right, so, as a third-party interloper... I put it to you, an employee of Affinity Water Limited, Viola, that Intercredit International will buy debts off yourself. Is that correct?
No, they don't buy debts off us.
Right, so how do Intercredit International Limited, a third-party interloper, how do they... claim money for you then?
Well, they're an external agency that we use if an account is overdue and has been for some time.
Right, so you sell the account to Intercredit International?
We don't sell the account to them, no.
So what gives them the right then to get involved and start sending people threatening letters, threatening to take them to court?
Well, they are employed by ourselves, sir. As regards, well, basically, they get sent the accounts that are overdue, but without looking at your account, I as I said, without any information, I can't tell you the status of it, or have you got a postcode or a customer number I can have a look at?
Yes.
And your name, sir?
I won't be giving you my name at the moment.
Right, well, can I take the first line of the address then?
I won't be giving you any more information at the moment because I believe that you may think that you're telling me the truth, but I don't think you are. And I'm not accusing you of lying to me deliberately. I just think that you don't have the correct information. Because... I don't see how a third-party interloper can be employed by yourselves to collect money on your behalf. That's not their job. A third-party interloper will buy a debt off you, which nullifies any debt that you have with a customer, and it's then up to Intercredit International Limited to try and recover the money that they spent in buying the debt off you.
No, that isn't the case, sir, I can assure you.
How do you know? Are you directly involved in the employment of Intercredit International Limited?
No, but I am aware that they're not actually... We don't sell our debts on the sir. I mean, if you would like, I can put you through to our debt collection
system. A debt collection and credit reference agency authorised and regulated by the Financial Conduct Authority for accounts formed under the Consumer Credit Act 1974, amended 2006, licence number 000057. They are a third-party interloper. They buy debts off companies. When a debt has been bought, then the debt has gone. You do not employ Intercredit International Limited to collect money on your behalf.
Well, yes, we do, sir.
Right. So, if you employ them purely to collect money on your behalf, then there will be a contract as such, won't there, between yourself and them?
Yes.
Right. Well, surely a contract should also be between a customer and those people as well.
But I don't actually know what you're asking me, sir.
I'm asking you... Well, I'm not asking you, actually. I'm telling you that if you employ Intercredit International Limited purely to collect on your behalf, then there will be a contract between yourselves and Intercredit International Limited, yes?
Yes, sir.
There will be a signed contract for them to do it as a company.
Well, I wouldn't be exactly sure of the exact correspondence.
Right, see, now we're not exactly sure because you do not have the correct information, either that, or now you're trying to backtrack because I know that you're lying.
Well, I'm not trying to backtrack anything, sir.
I'm not being rude, but could you please put me on to somebody a bit higher than yourself who does know exactly what I'm talking about then, please?
Well, as I just said earlier, I can put you through to the actual internal debt collectors department if you'd like, sir.
Yes, please.
May I take your name?
No, you cannot.
Okay, no problem, sir. I'll put you straight through.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello there. Your call's been transferred to debt collection team.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, how am I speaking to you, please?
I won't be giving you my name at the moment, I'm afraid, love, for my own protection.
Okay. Well, how may I help?
Well, I'd just like to point out that I am also recording this phone call as well for my own protection.
Okay.
Right. Do you work for Viola or Affinity Water?
I personally work for Affinity Water, yes.
Right, so you do not work for Intercredit International Limited?
No.
You don't? Right.
No.
Well, the lady who just put me through to you has just told me that Affinity Water employ Intercredit International Limited to do their collections for them. So if you employ Intercredit International Limited to do your collections, that means that you, working in the collections department, work for Intercredit International Limited.
We have an internal debt collection team, which is where I work in, and we also pass accounts on to Intercredit International as one of our debt collection agencies to work on our behalf.
Right. Now, please remember, I am recording this call for my own safety, okay? Now, you just said that you pass debts on to Intercredit International Limited, yes?
Yeah.
Right. Well, by doing that, you are actually committing fraud. Because you are passing on a, what you call a debt, onto another company. That company does not have a contract with your customer.
Right, okay. Well, did you want to take it up to with our regulator? They are the one who authorised us to do that.
Well, I know that Intercredit International Limited are a third-party interloper. I also know that when you say you pass it on to them, you actually mean that you've sold the debt to them.
No, we don't sell the debt. We don't sell debts on.
Please remember, I am recording this, and I will use this in court if necessary.
Okay. The way it works is we pass the debt on to them for a certain period of time. If they fail to recover on that debt, the debt is passed back to us. As I said, I think the best person to speak to is probably Ofwat, our regulator.
Right. So, sorry, can you just repeat that, please? You pass it on to Intercredit International Limited. If they fail to get the money, then it goes back to yourselves.
That's right.
Right, so hold on a second, please. Can I just take your name for the record, please? Because this is being recorded.
No, I mean, you haven't given me your name.
Well, you can call me Scream Crow Face.
No, I'm not.
No, well, that's my name. That's what you can call me. Well, okay, I'll just carry on for a moment then, okay? I have here a letter from Intercredit International Limited.
I'm talking to, with all due respect, I'm not prepared to carry on this conversation.
Oh, why not?
What
can I ask, why not?
Because I don't know who I'm talking to.
I just said you can call me Scream Crow Face. That's my name.
That's not acceptable.
Why is it not acceptable?
Because I know that's your name. That's not your name.
It is my name. I just told you my name is Scream Crow Face. If I told you my name was John Doe, you've got no way of knowing whether or not that's my name, do you?
Okay. Whoever you are.
You can call me, okay, call me Peter then. Okay, you can call me Peter, okay? And I've, no, please, I'm still talking. Well, there you go. What have they got to hide, people? If I was you, I'll just start ignoring them. You can hang up, love, but you've been found out. Affinity Water, also known as Veolia Central, they will pass on your debt to Intercredit International Limited. If Intercredit International Limited fail to collect this money, then the debt gets referred back to Affinity Water. But wait a minute. Intercredit International sent me a letter saying that I'm going to be receiving court costs and solicitor's fees and statutory interest. and they're going to take me to court and get the bailiffs to come round. Oh, good. I'll make some fucking YouTube stars out of them as well. You heard her yourself, people. She said that if these people, Intercredit International Limited, if they fail to collect the debt, then the debt gets referred back to them. But how can the debt get referred back to them if you go to court? Surely if it's gone to court, then you have to pay it, no matter what. I'm sorry for the language, people, but I'm really fucking pissed off this morning now. I need to go chill out. New vid coming soon, people.